doesn't wear any makeup. So this Christmas break, I felt like it would be fun to do a get ready with me video, and I can post it for her. So this is my first tutorial. If I suck at it, don't make fun of me. But here we go, get ready with me. Okay, the first thing I start with is a moisturizer to put on before my makeup, just so that it evens out my skin. And I'm using Too Faced. It's just like a nice moisturizer and primer, and it helps make all of my makeup really smooth. I do have a lot of acne scars, so I like to make sure that my makeup is as smooth as possible.
And the primer
helps. So after that, I put on my foundation. I use MAC Studio Fix. Full coverage, because again, I have like a ton of acne scars, so it's really
nice to get that all covered up.
Then this, I use a beauty blender. I've already got it wet, and I just
blend it all
over. This bathroom is super backlit, so I'm hoping this light will help.
Everything up.
Okay. I'm trying to get a little bit in my
hairline
so that it's nice.
My bathroom has a lot of mirrors, so.
Which is the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer. This is like the most full, oops, the watch there. Full coverage concealer.
Oh, it's really nice. So I pat
that in under my eye on both sides. And I kind of like wing it out from other YouTube videos I watched. I used to like make a triangle here.
And then I take whatever
product is left and I cover up my acne spots that are like really prominent, so that just so that it kind of hides.
Because it's just a little bit sucky
to be an adult with acne, but here we are. So then next, and I always leave my hair up out of my face. Next I'm gonna take my MAC Light Plus Mineralized Skin Finish and just a big brush. I'm just gonna rub it. Actually, I need to clean my brushes really bad, so I just don't look at that. I got a new brush cleaner that I'm super excited about, but I'm just gonna rub this like really lightly around. And then I take a featherweight complexion brush and my Anastasia Beverly Hills loose setting powder. I just have it in translucent. Oh my god, my eyelashes are falling down. I'm getting them done tomorrow, so that's kind of and I just load up, like especially underneath my eyes, to keep it bright under there. And it just kind of sets it, and then I do my whole face. And honestly, I found this is the best way to keep the oil off my skin and to keep my skin looking pretty, like, even, especially with my acne. I used to do this in a later step, and I just this week actually, and I always do on top of my lid, just this week I started doing this sooner because I noticed that when I use some of the other products first and then put this on, like, it would make my acne look darker. And so then it was like, not business, because I'm just trying to hide it. Okay, so right now I have like a good layer underneath my eyes, and it's gonna help keep my eyes clean when I'm doing my eyeshadow. So next I do my eyebrows. I use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Wiz in medium brown. This is really weird
to do this on a camera.
Okay, like, don't trust that. Sorry, guys. So I just kind of do like really short strokes. I have really like weird eyebrows. They're not the same. So that's why I pencil them in. But I don't do anything thick, just because I want them to still look natural. So I just kind of like brush it in so it still looks like my natural. Fill that in right there. They're just, it's weird. I have like one eyebrow for my mom and one for my dad, and so I just kind of make them look a little bit the same, but still like super natural. I don't like to fill them in all the way because it just doesn't, I don't feel like it flatters my face. So I still like to see like a little bit of the hair. There we go, that's better. Okay, so next I use my Naked 2 palette. I have tons of palettes, but I like anything that's brown based. So I'm gonna use the color Tease, and I'm going to put it in like the outer like third kind of half, and then like up into my crease, but I leave the center like open. And then I use the shade Booty Call. It's like a really light glitter shade, and I go all over the lid and then blend out my crease so that it kind of blends it.
Dogs are barking outside,
but then it kind of like does it for me. I don't try to wear like too much eyeshadow, but then I'm gonna take this smudge brush and use the color Snake Bite, and I don't wear eyeliner. Instead, I use eyeshadow just because it's not as harsh, and especially with having the eyelash extensions, I just don't feel like you need it. So I'm using my smudge brush and just along the lash line, I just kind of literally smudge it. And then I'm gonna take this, it's like an eyebrow pencil, but I just use the angle brush side, and I use the color Blackout. And then this, I make, this is like my liner, and I just wipe this like right on the edge of the lashes, which I'm like blind looking into this light, so hopefully this looks good, but whatever. Okay. So then that's my liner. I don't do that every day. It just kind of depends, but since my niece wanted this video, I'm just doing my makeup that I like most of the time do. So I have drip right here from my eyeshadow. So that same fluffy featherweight complexion brush, I just take it and I wipe away the powder, and that black and brown is gone, which is so nice. Once I heard about that, I was like, dear Lord, where has that been all my life? Because before I used that, I was just not business. Then I'm gonna take my bronzer, which this bronzer I've had literally forever, which I should probably get a new one, but it's the CoverGirl True Blend Minerals. I don't even know if they still have it, but it's in medium. And I'm gonna take my fluffy flawless bronzer brush, and I'm just gonna rub it around my face so that I just don't look super pasty, because I'm not super tan. But so this is just gonna kind of make it so it's, I have a little bit of color and I don't look totally like a psycho. My husband is really tan, so I like to look like I have a teeny bit of color on. take my, it's called Roller Lash. It's by Benefit Cosmetics. It's brown. I watched a video, a makeup video like 2 years ago, and they said they use brown mascara on their bottom so it looks softer but still gives that look. And I've always used black, and I started using it and I actually love it because it doesn't make my eyes look as small as they used to look when I had like all this like really thick lash, like these thick black lashes on top and then thin like black lashes on the bottom. It was nice, so I was like, I'm kind of stuck with it because it just did more of the look I wanted instead of instead of my eyes just looking super small. So really should be good. I just try to do this like really lightly because I don't want it to be super thick. The thicker part I do is like in the corner, so it kind of like makes my eyes go like that. Okay, so then I use NARS Deep Throat Blush, and I have a blush. Oh no, actually it's a contouring brush, but this is the favorite blush brush that I've. I am not a huge blush person, so I just like it. And I always kind of pink my cheekbones up so I can see. It's not doing a ton of product because, like I said, I was cleaning my brushes last night. And it's a little more cleaner than others, so now it's like there's no product on it. And then the very last thing I do, well, the second last thing I do, I use the Becca Cosmetics and Rose Quartz Highlighter, and I just kind of go right here on my cheekbones so I get a little something. And I like it because it's pink, so it kind of blends into my blush. Then I always do the tip of my nose so that when we take pictures, it's cute. And then I grab a little bit more and I put it on the under part of my eyebrow. There's like a teeny bit of shine there. And then that's about done. I'm gonna brush out my eyelash extensions and getting on film tomorrow, so I'm super excited. But my lips, I'm gonna brush my teeth in a second, so my lips won't look like that. But before I take my hair down, my hair's still wet from my shower, so before I take my hair down, I always use the MAC Prep and Prime Fix Plus, and this just sets my makeup. I love it, it's super light, and I feel like it works, but I feel like you can use any. I've used a few different ones, but this is just because I'm MAC makeup, I just buy it there. So I do a bunch of squirts, let it dry. Okay, I'm gonna brush my teeth and then start my hair. Okay, so I just brushed my teeth and checked in the mirror, and luckily I don't look like a pale ghost. I was a little worried with this light because I've never used this ring light and the fact that it's backlit, but that's okay. So, brushed my teeth and I wiped off all the product that was on my lips. Next, I'm gonna use, I've just found this, it's Aquaphor's Lip Repair Immediately Relief. I love the Aquaphor brand. I always wear chapstick, I'm not really like a lipstick, lip gloss person. Sometimes I wear it, but I'm more of a chapstick person. So after I do my makeup, I just put this on, and there is a little bit of product still, but I just kind of blend it in. And then it comes like a nude situation,
which I think is cute, but not everybody might.
But then I always have issues with my lips being chapped, even though I try to drink so much water. But it just gives a little bit like softer vibe happening there. Next, I'm going to dry my hair. So before I dry my hair, I just like a month ago, 6 weeks ago, I put blonde in my hair, which I haven't had blonde in my hair in a long time. And so I've been trying to take care of it a little bit better. So I'm gonna use this, it's R & Co. It's Waterfall Moisture Chime Lotion. My hairstylist used it. And she rubbed it in my hair, it smelled so good, but it also made my hair really soft and way less frizzy. So So I use like about that much, rub it through my hands, and I'm going to put it through my hair and then go to the roots. And I do this before I brush it. So it's kind of nice though, because when I'm combing it through, it's like hard because like it's a little bit brushed. So and then I'm gonna take my brush and go through my hair with it, and it's already pretty much like brushed for me. I think you're supposed to start with the bottom. I don't always do that. But anyways, so then I just kind of like shake my hair out, and then it's like gets it all over. The brush helps evenly like product through your hair, so it's really nice. I've never felt like my hair was oily or anything, which that's something I really worry about with using any product. I cannot stand when my hair has like any sort of oil in it, so when I use something, it really has to work. So I bought it like really skeptical, but it actually really does work, so. But I'm gonna dry my hair and then I will come back to style it. All right, so my hair is dry. I try to brush through it when I dry it, especially when I'm going to style it straight. I'm gonna do it straight today just because that's what I typically do. I do curl my hair like half and half. It looks really pretty with the blonde in it when it's curled, but since it's winter break, and I'm not really doing anything, I'm just gonna leave it straight. So, completely dry. So I'm gonna start above my ears and I kind of swoop down to make a section of hair. I just clip it on top of my head, and I'm using a Paul Mitchell straightener that I've literally had for like 7 years. I was just telling my mother-in-law that I can't believe this straightener is like making it. It's like trying to die on me, but today it's gonna work, so here we go. I'm just straightening like pretty big sections. I love the straightener because it's like really wide. Before I always had cheese. Love those too, so I'm not sure what I'm gonna do next, but I just kind of straighten each section a couple times, flat iron it, and it's already pretty straight, so this is really for me, like if I don't straighten my hair, it gets all frizzy and like it's just poofy. It just helps to make it look really clean, I feel like. So I just kind of go through a couple times. Sorry, it's getting stuck on the counter because I'm doing my hair in a different place than I normally do because of the way this light is set up. I brush through it really quick. Then I do the same thing, but now I go like right here, like another section, and I try to get all of what's at the back of my hair, like gonna lay flat back without a part, just so that all of it gets straightened evenly. And I brush it out. Straightening my hair really doesn't take that long, which is really nice. So especially like in the mornings when I wake up a little late because Brielle's like up at night or I just don't have time in the morning, I straighten my hair a lot. I don't know if you guys can see it, but the blonde is really pretty. It looks more like in real life, you can see it better, but. So I keep just straightening through this section. It's a little bit thicker, so I just go like a little bit slower, and I try to make sure that I'm getting each thing kind of evenly. I used to curl my hair underneath when I straightened it to like finish it off.
I don't know, I just don't do that anymore.
I'm feeling fancy. It doesn't really stay very well on my hair though. So, that should be that section, and it stays pretty soft. Then I go right down the middle, so I do not part my hair in the middle because I just don't. I actually am thinking about switching my part because I think people look skinnier with those kind of parts, so I might So I just do right down the middle, and then I go ahead and straighten this down. And I like the ones around my face to be pretty straight, because I kind of, I don't know, I flick my hair or like tuck it behind my ear. I try not to, because I really, I don't prefer the ear tuck look, but I like it just to be straight. So
that's nice.
Have a ton of baby hairs all around the front of my face from nursing and pumping. I nursed for a year and pumped until my daughter was 20 months old. And so literally, I swear I went through like those hair sheds like every 3 months, which they like say is normal because of the hormones, but it literally gave me like, we call them wings. But they gave me like the worst wings. And so I feel like I always have, like I can't, I'm not somebody that can just like put my hair up. I just kind of shake my head. I just like did that bit. But I don't really know where my part is. And so it just, like I just do it where it falls. And right now it's falling right there. So that's what's happening. But you can see like this cowlick, it just kind of like, but it's all from nursing. So, I'm like really hoping my hair gets back to normal soon, but I don't know, it's been 9 months since I stopped pumping and we're still dealing with the growth, so here we are. But that's okay. So I'm just gonna keep doing the same thing. My cowlick, I tried to like get as close to my head, which I burned myself before. But it's just, look at that, it's having a party today. Well, that's fine. I'm going to give that side a break because it's kind of hot, so we'll do this side. And then just kind of go through. Gosh, this made my hair look really red. I always tell my stylist that I do not want my hair to look like brass. I've been using a purple shampoo, but luckily I'm going in soon, so I guess. It's been more ashy this time, which is really good. Literally never talk to myself while I'm getting ready, so sorry. Pulling it through. Like I said, I like to go over it like a bajillion times because I don't just do really thin sections. Like this probably has like part of the old section and this section. So I always have to do it a few times. But then I feel like it gets a good blend and it lays nicely instead of being just like totally section out and tilting back. I just kind of grab chunks and I'm not like super specific about it. I don't know, I never have been, so it's worked out fine for me. I always stress out and ask my husband, I'm like, is the back straight? Yeah, looks good. And then, so, there, it's pretty straight, pretty good to go for the day. I don't usually do any sort of product after, just because I put the product on before. I will say, since starting to use that Arn Co. stuff before, since starting to use the Arn Co. stuff before I dry my hair, it's a lot smoother and a lot shinier after I'm done. So I don't really feel the need to put anything in my hair, but yeah. Okay, thanks for getting ready.